Now we have another case study. I want to tell one more that you will find the voting positions at the official website later on. So be prepared to collect your votes during the day. Now it's time for us to hear about surveillance of public roads and squares. Užice Safe City Project. Technical support engineer with us with Dahua Technology. Mr. Stojanović, is it you? Yeah. Welcome. Dobrodošli na staro engleskom. When you're ready, your 15 minutes will start. Ready?
Yeah.
Steady.
And
go.
Thank you, first of all, for those nice words. I'm for the first time on Adria Summit as a speaker, so I will try to be short and to fit in these 15 minutes. But the biggest problem with the technicians that we can speak actually a whole day about our equipment, you know, about the sensors, about the electronic, about the everything. So I will try to give you just a few details, and the rest of the things you will hear from us in the coffee break. Okay, like they said, I'm Alexander, but a lot of them call me Alex. Some of them, they don't call me just a type on WeChat or WhatsApp, like a big help with big letters, like help, we need to finish this today. And in most of the cases, it's like that. But I'm actually the technical support engineer in Dahua for 3 years. Before that, I was in the similar industry. And today, I will not speak about my company because a lot of this information you can find on our website. Yes, we are big, we have a lot of employees, we have an offices all around the world, and we have a lot of products and we have a lot of solutions. So we have 20,000 products in China, and for overseas market we have more than 10,000 products. So we can read at least half a year the data sheet and the specification of all of our products that we can offer to you. So general information you can see on our website. Also, because we are coming from Serbia, I will introduce you one part of Serbian team later on in our social networks. You can find a lot of videos and a lot of useful information about the projects that we did in Serbia on our YouTube channel, because we like to record with the phone and to test in front of the camera and to show you in real what is happening when you choose our EPOE switch, or if you choose our ultra series of camera, or if you choose something else. So a lot of videos you can find on our YouTube page. Just type it and you will see. One more important thing is, of course, Facebook. All of us like Facebook. So use a few minutes. Go to our official Dahua Serbia Facebook page, like, share, and send one short message with your name and surname, and our colleagues will prepare, for the fastest one, will prepare one small gifts. Of course, LinkedIn page, it's common now, so for the big events and the big announcement, we will also share on the official LinkedIn page. Okay, so today, before we start, I want to say that I'm not here alone. I have at least 10 people, but I will mention my colleagues from Serbia, this table, and Ana Bajović is our marketing manager. So actually, she's responsible for all Adria region, and she can help you a lot with the Dahua brand. Daniela Terziorski, business development manager and from now project manager for North Macedonia. I'm also responsible for the North Macedonia from this year. And my dear colleague, technician, and my big help, Luis, also technical support engineer. We have two more people here responsible for North Macedonia. It's very important. They came from China. So because of that, I don't have the name in the PPT. It's our sales engineer for North Macedonia, George, and you can meet him outside, and our regional manager, Artur. So if you need any information, please contact us in the break and we will try to help you. Okay, booth 6, it's easy to find. you probably found the cocktail, so you will find also the boot. Okay, let's get started. About the projects and generally traffic project, this project is not so big, but it's very important to share some information with you because it's more and more popular in all those countries like Serbia, Bosnia, Montenegro, Macedonia, because we have more and more requests about the traffic. We are also good in some other projects and solutions, but actually there is not so many information about the traffic projects. Now it's starting to be more and more popular. There is a money in it, and police know that, you know. So they just calculate how much money they can earn, and they ask only one thing: when everything will be paid and when we will start to earn? After 1 month or more months, you know, how much time we need to wait. Of course, they have more requests and the questions, the normal one. And we had a conversation with our system integrator and the police office in Užice. Actually, Užice is a small town, and you can see what can happen in that small town. Actually, there is no so many violations, there is no too many people and car. But for those who don't know, the Užice is between Čačak and Zlatibor, so it's on Ibarska Magistrala, one road that is has a lot of cars, especially in the summer season, because that is the main road to the Montenegro, to the coast. So we have a lot of drivers. They are very tired because they are driving from Belgrade and around Užice, Čačak. They want to be fast and stay on Zlatibor for a lunch. So we have a lot of violations actually is happening in Užice. Some of them are, of course, red light running and overspeed, the most important. But we had a lot of different requests from the police how to collect those data, how to store that on the proper way, and how to find the best way to make the ticket, to customize and to simplify for the police officers that are doing that job every day. So we had different kind of challenges. You know, it's popular to say the challenges. Actually, we had a request, we had a problems, you know, and we needed to find some kind of solution for that. But actually, yeah, it was a challenge. So we decided to offer them two kind of solutions and to let them to choose. Just choose and you will see. Maybe the option one or option two, later we will see. So the first choice was the most common, like I want to say in Serbia, just put as much as you can the lane, the policeman, and then destroy all the cars and decrease the speed on 20 kilometers per hour, and then we will not have the overspeed, red light running, or anything else. So the first choice was to calculate how many lane policemen we need for Užice town, and that's it. And the second choice was Dahua Safe City. In Dahua Safe City, actually, when we are promoting the Safe City and when we are using the official marketing presentation, it's always some PPT which is showing the logo, the cameras, the branding, but there is no a lot of information what is actually Safe City. Safe City should be a combination of the different kind of cameras and other kind of equipment doing some smart work, and of course on the back end it should be easy for the operator to handle one town. And now we are talking about the small town, which is Užice, but later on we will work in Novi Sad, in Niš, in Belgrade, in Skopje, in much bigger towns. And as I always like to say, we invest a lot of money in the equipment, but actually in front of that video wall, we always put one man, and that one man is looking at the 100 and 200 cameras. So we need to improve that. Okay, for this project, we divided everything into the three kind of phases, let's say. The first one and the most common one is the general CCTV, And actually, that is something that we already know. It's a good camera, good encoder, good switching network, HDDs, 30 days of recording, and everything else, you know. The second part, then most important, is if we invest in the phased one, how we will pay that? Because general CCTV, we don't have anything from that, you know. You don't have money from that, you know. So you need the phase one. Phase one, phase two, actually. Phase two is a traffic part of project. Cover the crossroad with the red light running enforcement cameras, and also cover with the NNPR cameras and cover with the radar. So with those few devices, you will have violation tickets. And later on, I will tell you how many per day or per week. And you will not believe, in Užice. Okay. And that is just the front end of equipment, you know. We are used to work with those kind of devices. But actually, we need to have a back-end equipment, and we are forgetting that we need that logic, good logic in the back-end, because, as I said, we will have only one operator, or maybe two per shift, that is handling all city, from the police station, of course. Okay, so, like I said, in Užice, we put a lot of cameras, different shape and different pixels and different infrared and another features that is common for the cameras. We combine with the PTZ cameras mostly in the park. Yeah, thank you. And we put one emergency tower, which we are always put in front of the schools, on the crossroads and very important areas, so the citizens can easily call the police station without using the mobile phone. Everything is integrated on one platform. For the traffic part, we use our cameras, the old model, ITC 302, old because in China everything is old after 1 month, you know, they like to make new models every month, but okay. NNPR cameras, and we put one in front of a city, from the Čačak direction, and the second one is exit from the city to the Zlatibor. So actually, we are collecting all the plates from all the cars that are passing by the Užice or through the Užice. So actually, we have data. If something happened in the town, in any area, actually, we can locate the car, see the shape, and maybe try to find the license plate in the database. Next solution is our red light running solution that we did in the center of the city. We combined two type of cameras. The first one, ITC 602, is for the NNPR. And the second one, ITC 235, according to the Serbian law, is a camera that will provide you the color image at the night mode. So we will know for sure which color of the car was at the 1 o'clock a.m., you know. Of course, is like in every solution, we put that redundancy. So we have edge storage, and we have some central storage. And after Užice, be careful if you are using that road. After Užice, when you passing the Užice and going to Zlatibor, you have one radar, and the speed limit is 50 kilometers per hour. So be careful when you are coming from Zlatibor or you are going to Zlatibor near Užice. But in a lot of towns, we have our radars, everything is certificated, and the best one is that is all in one device. So in that device, it's stationary radar. We have included an NNPR camera plus the radar module. So everything is easy. You will have a picture with the speed, with your license plate. So everything that you need to do is to pay that ticket to the government, of course. Okay. And in this project, we had a lot of flash lamps, accessories, and of course, all network is done by Dahua industrial switches. Okay, in monitoring center, maybe the most important, we have VMS platform. It's customized for the Serbian market. It's on Serbian language. And we made a customized violation ticket according to our law. So that part is also good with the Chinese company because they always want to help you to customize something for you and to help you about the projects. Central Enterprise Storage EVS 7000. Why? Because we have a redundant controller board inside. We have a redundant network module, power module, and we have a lot of HDDs inside. So actually, we have one good solution to store everything, and we have, of course, watermark protection of everything. Professional decoder for video wall, just to provide you a clear and smooth image on the video wall. And actually, now we are doing the similar things in another towns. This is just a raw pictures that we took from our phone just to see what is happening on the field. It's never fancy, you know. It's always like that. We are hanging somewhere and we are trying to fix. And on the end, but not end for today, we have the new cameras. They call them II traffic cameras. But I will tell you more on our boot. It's a boot 6. You can see them. We hide them a little bit, but we will tell you more. It's more about the video analysis that we will use in the next project. And those new cameras we will have very soon in one town, also in Serbia. On the end, I just want to mention our distributors in North Macedonia. So if you have any questions, just feel free to ask them. Thank you very much.